Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Thank you for your patience. I hope you are all here waiting for my presentation. Sorry for the delay that we got because of some small technical problems. And thank you for waiting. I'm from No Composites. And Eskim and Tescom are our distributor in Turkey. Our head office is in France. We have a company in Italy, one in UK, and one in China. No Composites, we are producer of resins and gel coats, pigment pastes, and many other specialty products. Our head office in France is based in the north of Paris, about 150 kilometers north of Paris. We are 30 years old. We have our own R&D lab. We are about 120 people in the world. Our policy is very simple, okay? We're based on assistance to our customer. We work hands in hands with them to support them. We bring them solutions and we try to customize our products according to their needs and applications. This is our Italian plant, actually, where we are producing resins. So, to be by the logic of itself, in Turkey, we are based in France and in Italy. So by the logic of itself, we are not here present in Turkey to sell standard products. There are only two things which we can sell in Turkey is our specialty products, which have given us a world reputation. So these two specialty products are, I'm tempted to say zero shrink tooling resin, but I would not say that because I guess there are some chemists here, and saying zero shrink tooling resin would mean ideality, and ideality does not exist. It's just a utopia. So we have very low shrink tooling products for mold production, and we have fire retardant system for railway, marine, and construction. For construction, I will come later because I think the construction industry, the composite construction industry in Turkey is not so well developed as in Netherlands and in Dubai and Qatar. So our low shrink tooling resin, we have two sorts, polyester base and vinyl ester base. The difference between these three is, this is a market product, okay, which is meant for low price customers, very low shrink. This one is for, let's say, high grade customers who are ready to pay the price to have a very special molds. With this product, this 2550, it's a tooling resin. Basically, the standard tooling resin, the ratio of resin to glass is 4 resin to 1 glass. But with this one, the ratio of resin to glass is 2 resin to 1 glass, which means that in your mold has a higher percentage of glass. And the mechanical strength of your mold is given by the glass content and not by the resin content. So to give you an idea, this resin was formulated on special demands from Beneteau Jeannot Group, which is one of the biggest boat producers in Europe. They wanted a mold which would be very light, stronger than standard molds. So the only way we could figure it out was that you would use less resin, but at the same time, the same glass content. Now, this vinyl ester resin is for people who are using epoxy resins and gel coats, and they are making their molds to be able to post you at a temperature of about 150 to 180 degrees Celsius. Many people think that if I'm using a polyester resin to make my mold, I can post you till 80 degrees, which is right, which is correct. And then they say, okay, I will pay my epoxy 4 or 5 times than a normal polyester tooling resin, and I will be able to post you my mold at 150, 180 degrees Celsius. But you should know that actually the HDT of epoxy resins is approximately 300 degrees Celsius. And epoxy is mostly used actually to make molds, which are meant to cure at 300 degrees Celsius. So using epoxy to make a mold which you need to post you at 180 degrees Celsius is a waste of money. So if you use this sense, this way of thinking, you can go for our vinyl ester tooling resin. We have the complete vinyl ester system. Oops, sorry, I went too fast. So we have our vinyl ester system, which is used in big parts like in the wind industry, where this is the wind industry in China. And you know China is the biggest consumer of wind turbines in the world. If not now, but it will be it's a growing market of about 8 to 10% per year. And this is our vinyl ester system, 100% vinyl ester molds to make, for the wind energy, wind turbines, etc., wind blades. So this is our vinyl ester system, which is used mostly for molds which are post-cure at 150, 180 degrees Celsius, where you don't need to pay the price of epoxy system to post-cure at such temperature, right? I just come back on the other, now on fire retardant system. Fire retardant system, I'll not speak on French norms 92501, because this is the past. BS476 is also the past, more or less, but now with Brexit, maybe it will be trendy. We have the trend now is EN45545, HL2 certified products. This is for railway. And then there's another one which is coming in construction industry is EN13501-1. This is for construction. Because more and more you will have in Europe composites which will be used in the building industry. I will give you some examples. I will come back again on that. Yeah, sorry. It has been a little bit late, like me, this morning. Okay. So let me start with the railway industry. Now the trend, the European trend, is EN45545-2. And the certification which is very common, is HL2. For HL2, we have this system, okay, our gel coat, own gel coat, and our resin ready to use, which will give HL2. This is mostly meant for railway industry. We have a system under test for infusion, or RTM, which will be ready in November. It is this system. We have a gel coat, we have a skin coat, we have the resin applied by infusion process, so, and then the gloss. So we will give you the whole package to get HL2 R17, because in HL2 you have R1, R2, till R17. And this is mostly meant for the nose of the train, right? And now we have also HL3, which is the most severe grade in EN45545. But HL3 is not yet very common because HL3 is an intumescent gel coat. When we speak about intumescent gel coat, means it's a gel coat which when burnt will form like a cloud. And intumescent gel coat are very bad to hydrolysis or humidity in the air. So basically, people who are looking for HL-free products, they are sanding the gel coat and applying a paint over it, right? These are our customers or contractors to whom we are supplying our fire retardant today. In France, still Russia, and we have also big projects for the Chinese fast trains. This has been one of our products which are certified for Citadis. So anywhere where Alstom is proposing the Citadis train, this is a Citadis train. Wherever Alstom proposes our Citadis trains, people are bound to use our gel coat and our resin. That is our complete system. Same for a project called MFF 2000. So this is another one of another expertise in railway industry. I was speaking before about construction, which is not yet very trendy, but it will become. You know, there is in Dubai, there will be Expo, Universal Expo 2020, in the year 2020. And in Qatar, there will be the World Cup. So in Qatar, in Dubai, and in Bahrain, all the many of the construction that will take place very soon will be in composites. But they are not looking for these norms. They are looking for a norm called ASTM E 84. This also we do have, but unfortunately, I did not put it on this presentation. But just you can keep it in mind, right? So for Euroclass, it's EN 13501, and there are three ratings which are very demanding. Okay, it's BS1D0, BS3D0, CS3D0, and the most severe one is BS1D0. It was the first construction project in composites, which took place some years ago, maybe some 4 years ago, in Netherlands. And you know, Netherlands are advanced in architecture, right? So they use this system to do panels like this was the building. Everything is in composites. I mean, the facades is all in composites. It's our gel coat and our resins in this facade, if you want. So you can check that on internet. It's a, well, the project was called SKU, but the building itself is called Stad Kantoor and is in Utrecht in Netherlands. Well, now, I've seen our competitors tomorrow and after tomorrow will speak about low styrene products, but maybe fortunately I'm the first one to speak about that. So now we have already developed low styrene content products for three sectors: automobile, marine, and sanitary. For us, having low styrene products is one thing, but having low styrene products for sanitary, because sanitary is a big market in Germany, we have these three norms with the certifications. That is, when you use a gel coat for sanitary, well, for high-grade customers, they are looking for anti-proliferation of bacteria, anti-scratch, and some sanitary norms. So we have a gel coat which is low styrene content. It contains about 25% of styrene compared to a standard gel coat which is approximately 35% of styrene. So we have it for the three sectors: automobile, marine, and sanitary. Well, thank you very much for your attention, and thank you for having waited so long. So if you have any question, I would be more than happy to answer. So it was brief, but I prefer to make brief things, brief and simple, than too long things where you get annoyed. And some people were sleeping already, so. Yes. Yes.
How long do you project the lifetime of this?
Lifetime, basically, so we cannot project the lifetime. We can just give you the test certificate. And basically, what is important in a gel coat is the delta E value, how it changes over time. So we have simulated these delta E values. And basically, it depends on which gel coat you are using. But this gel coat 886, basically, we have projected it. The delta E values changes very little, because a good delta E value should be approximately 0.5, right? So the change between zero, it goes to 0 or to 1. It's very slight. We have simulated it for 30 years. There will be a slight difference in delta E, but which is almost invisible by naked eyes. Yeah, gel coat 886. This is the best gel coat we have for exterior applications. It's this one, but it was used in this project. Gel coat 886. Yeah. And it's not just from our test, but also the architects, they tested it according to their methods and all these things. Yeah.
How is the climate affecting the...
The climate?
The climate. Dubai and Netherlands is extreme climate changes.
Yes.
Netherlands is humid.
Dubai also is humid, huh? Dubai,
so
Bahrain, Qatar.
Very hot.
Yes, but we have the climate chamber. The climate chamber where you have this alternate climate change in the chamber itself, where you have light, QUVA, and coming humidity. So in that, you can estimate how your gel coat will behave in 30 years maximum. So 30 years basically is about, I think 3,000 hours. So yeah, it's a long work, 3,000 hours, but the delta E is very, very, is a very little change.
Thank you.